Welcome there, wrestling fans. You're watching Destiny Wrestling on the ProView Network.
This week, Hobo Hank returns to action for the first time since losing the DWO heavyweight title. But is he up for the challenge of former WWE superstar, the warlord of weird, Sin Bodhi? Catch the match right now on Destiny Wrestling on ProView TV.
Hello, Destiny Wrestling fans. I'm Jesse Lujan. We're here live at True Grit. Standing next to me, Matthew Robles. Matthew? Tonight, Chad...
Introduce me properly. I am the manager of the Destiny Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. All over the country, when I travel, everybody asks me, MK, who is Chad Thomas going to defend the title against? And I tell them, I honestly don't know. There is so much great talent out there. And that's what I'm doing here tonight. I could have been anywhere. I could have been in Hollywood. I could have been in New York. I could have been in Philadelphia. But tonight, I'm here in Albuquerque, New Mexico, to see who I can pick as the next victim of the champion, the Destiny Wrestling champion, Chad Thomas.
There we go. Couldn't have said it better myself. Back to the action in the ring. Hello, Destiny Wrestling fans. I'm Jesse Lujan. We're here live at True Grit. Standing next to me is former DWO heavyweight champion, Hobo Hank, who's going to take on tonight, Sin Bodhi. You have your hands full tonight.
Yeah, I do have my hands full tonight. And you know, and every time you say the word former, it makes me sick. It makes me sick to my stomach that Chad Thomas wears that belt proudly around his waist. And it's no thanks to you, is it, Matthew Robles? I know you had a hand in it, but you know what? Tonight, I can't think about that because I have a much bigger problem on my hands. I've got Sin Bodhi. I've got the former WWE superstar, the man who's done it all in this business, has been around the world, and he's good friends with Jake the Snake Roberts. You know, Sin claims that I cannot hook my Tornado DDT on him. Well, I claim I can. So you bring Tallulah Bell, I'll bring my DDT, and we'll see what happens. Let's get ready to rock.
Hello, DWO fans. Tonight at True Grit, Hobo Hank will be facing this man, the warlord of weird, Sin Bodhi. Sin, can you tell us your thoughts on tonight's match?
Well, you see, Sugar Lumps, I'm usually a very happy clown. But tonight, not so much. Hobo Hank, you have and continue to offend me. First of all, you were on the ENC podcast with my fellow Snow Mexicans, Edge and Christian, my brothers. I haven't even been on that show yet. How dare you butt in line? Secondly, Tommy Dreamer says that you are his favorite indie wrestler. Just shows you what that clown knows. But most of all, you think, as tough as you are, as talented as you are, as skilled as you are, and as brave as you are, my man, do you think the protege of Jake the Snake doesn't know every in and out of the DDT? Tilt World DDT, Pogo Stick DDT, Australian DDT, Zebra DDT, every kind of freaking DDT! You don't think I know how to negotiate that move, if nothing else in pro wrestling? You've got another thing coming, boy. But again, I'm a forgiving clown. But Tallulah Bell, she's not as forgiving as me. She will see you in that ring. Want to find out what that means? Stay freaking tuned. Do I look like I'm clowning around?
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
DWOWrestling.com presents Fight or Flight. Live September 9th from the Westside Community Center. With titles on the line and Dave Destiny 10 on the horizon, Fight or Flight is promised to be a night of hard-hitting action. This show will be filmed for TV episodes on the ProView Network every Monday at 5:30 p.m. on the Comcast Channel 26. Check us out on Facebook.com/DWOWrestling and at DWOWrestling.com.
Welcome back, wrestling fans!
Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Will the VDK, and we are joined here at ringside by none other than MK, Matthew Robles, the self-professed manager of champions, although his stock is rising.
I'm not self-professed, I am the manager of champions.
Can you show my boss the respect that he deserves, damn it?
That is true, Carney Rob. He is your boss. He is not mine. That is the beauty of what has happened. MK went from the director of competition, somebody that quite possibly could have put me out of work, but luckily, Adam Merrick, now the commissioner, MK losing his spot in that. I am sittled.
You know what? I voluntarily gave that up. I didn't lose it. I voluntarily gave it up. You know, it was a lot of work to do both things, so I never lost it. I gave that up.
And as we noticed, it's a factoid, if you will, from the MK Bandit, just like Carney Rob gives us the factoids, where they see things completely opposite than the rest of the world.
We see them right, not wrong. The same way our great president Donald Trump does, we see everything the right way.
Now let's get over here to what is happening in the ring, MK. We have Sin Bodhi, the Warlord of Weird, who has been making numerous appearances here in Destiny Wrestling. Couple wins, couple losses, but this guy is championship material.
Well, you gotta understand, Sin Bodhi's the Benny Briscoe of Destiny Wrestling. I mean, you've got to get through him to get to the championship. I mean, honestly, put all, you know, bias aside, this is the guy that you have to get through him if you want to be in that championship hunt. He is the man.
It is true. Sin Bodhi has traveled all over the world. He has done things that many wish that they could do. But coming out next, right here, is none other than our hometown hero, Albuquerque Zone.
Stop.
New
He's
Mexico
not a hero.
Zone. Easy now.
Wait
Hobo
for this.
Hank.
He put, this is like his idol.
This is a man who fights for the rights of everybody in this building, except president, company excluded. Hobo Hank, ladies and gentlemen, coming to the ring to face off.
I don't
off.
Hear the crowds cheering. I don't hear anything. Do you hear anything, Carney Rob?
I don't hear nothing. I do hear some of the
I hear
people.
A bunch of boos and hisses. And.
Oh, yeah. They hate this guy.
Yes. They hate him so much that these people bring him food, that these people give him money, that these people buy him merchandise. And when he was the heavyweight champion, Destiny Wrestling saw a wonderful rise in attendance, a wonderful rise in merchandise sales, and that can be
well,
attributed.
Well, that's because of me. That's because of me.
That can
that's
be
because I was director of competition. That's because I was marketing behind it. Please stop. He's a hobo.
It is true. He is a transient. It is true. He is a hobo. But what is also true is that he is the people's champion. He is the people's hobo. He is the man that people want to see, that people come and pay to see. And I would like to point out to you, MK, when he was the heavyweight champion, you were not the director of competition. So unlike your Trump fantasies here.
Yeah, we have we went over this with you guys many times. There's a plan in place. I'm here part of that plan. Now, the reason what you guys don't understand is what the reason why Destiny numbers are up is because of what Matthew Robles did. He got his TV deal. He got everything that this company has.
But let's just say this, though. I don't care what you want to say. He's a transient. He lives behind the frontier, whatever. The guy did beat Tommy Dreamer. I mean, he legitimately beat Tommy Dreamer. And that says a lot about the company that I think we can all agree is probably the best independent professional wrestling company in the country. And he beat Tommy Dreamer.
That is true, and it is possible tonight. Oh, as Sin Bodhi goes after him, he could also add Sin Bodhi to that resume. We will wait and see. Driving knees into Hobo Hank's head and big clubs over the back.
How long before this turns into just a Pier 6 brawl? I mean, there's you know, Hobo Hank, Sin Bodhi can both technically wrestle. They do well at technically wrestling, but how long before you think this breaks down to just a brawl?
Well, normally Hobo Hank is going to turn into a brawl quickly. He likes to bend the rules. He likes to cheat. Just like everybody else here in New Mexico, they cheat all the time. If it's not in, you know, if it's not on their wives or their spouses, they're cheating on their taxes. Heck, half of them even cheat and be here illegally. Can you believe that?
No, I understand that. You know, but, you know, we're seeing some wrestling here. But, I mean, what I really want to know is this going to be a wrestling match or a brawl?
Obviously, coming from both these two gentlemen, at any point it could go either way. I mean, these guys are going to be able to do submission holds that almost nobody has seen, but at the same time, wouldn't it just be easier for them to punch each other square in the face? And I could see that happening. Now, one thing I do want to put over to the fans at home, this is something that many of us did not know, but we were informed, is the Warlord of Weird, Sin Bodhi, has never been pinned by a DDT.
And he's never taken the DDT.
Hence never being pinned as well. So we've got Hobo Hank here, whose coup de grace, if you will, is the tornado DDT from the top rope there. And we've got Sin Bodhi.
Oh, he's biting him. Pinned. Come on.
Oh, he's just acting like Hobo Hank does. I mean, I've been bitten by that.
Oh, so there you go. That's what I'm talking about.
Back and forth right there. Both gentlemen, fair play. Turns one to the other, and it's the standoff, the square off again as we go here.
Now, my question is, who's the crowd behind, though? You know, who's the crowd behind?
Obviously, I think the crowd will back Hobo Hank. They do enjoy Sin Bodhi. His ability in the ring and some of the stuff he showed the live crowd here and also on television is just fantastic, and I think people are going to enjoy that, but I think the crowd is strictly behind Hobo Hank.
You know, I just think this is an amazing crowd. I mean, I've got to say, another near sellout here in Albuquerque.
Wibble there.
And oh. Well, I just want to say I think it's amazing what everybody has done here in Albuquerque. I mean, look at the crowd here. It's a great match. As much as I dislike Hobo Hank, I mean, look at this.
Yeah, it is something else. I mean, I'm rooting for Sin Bodhi all the way. You know, I just despise Hobo Hank. I don't like anything that he stands for. I hate the fact that he's, you know, he represents New Mexico. He's
big, like, scoop slam there. Sorry to cut you, gentlemen, off.
What I want to know is, why is he loved and not me?
Because these people here are used to loving people who are less.
Wait. Funnel cake here. Why don't you talk about this move, the funnel cake?
Oh, he's going to like this move.
Oh, and there it is. There it is. He just got keistered there. Hobo Hank just wore a bit of the funnel cake right off of Sin Bodhi. And back to the pit. Again. Turnabout is fair play for these two guys. They are so evenly matched. Some people say these guys are brawlers. Some guys say that these guys are old school. But what it is that they are is entertaining. These two gentlemen put it out there, and Sin Bodhi just caught the pit right after the funnel cake on Hobo Hank's face.
And here we go. It's starting to brawl outside, just like we were talking. Hobo Hank.
And another one.
I mean, this is a big test for Hobo Hank. It's a big test for Sin Bodhi, too. He's in the title hunt.
I would have to agree. Both these men are lined up. Now, the one thing I will disagree with you there, MK, is I don't believe that Hobo Hank has to prove anything. Obviously, he was our champion. Obviously, there were some serious shenanigans in that match that basically had him lose the belt to Chad Thomas. I think he should be getting his rematch right now, show.
I think we can agree that if Sin Bodhi beats Hobo Hank, Hobo Hank's got to be out of the title hunt. I don't care what you think about shoulda, coulda, woulda. He loses tonight, he's out of it.
I like to just say, look, he lost the first time. He should be back of the bus. He shouldn't even be in the conversation. You know, I think that, you know, the interference that Johnny saw, he should be up there being thought of. Sin Bodhi should be number one. But let's move Hobo back out where he belongs. Let's move him to the back of the bus, the back of the frontier.
You know what? I'm tired of talking about what shoulda, coulda, woulda. Let's focus on the match here. Let's let the play-by-play guy do his job. Let's see what you got, brother.
Easily, obviously, the one thing that I will point out outside of Hobo Hank's arm getting shredded is it is hilarious how our buddy there, Carney Robb, obviously referenced a 1950s racist reference. Thank you that, Carney Robb. We all appreciate your historic value here and your skewed view of the Americas. Now, let's get back here. We got just back and forth. Now, Will seems to be letting this go. in that sense. Obviously, I think that definitely could have been a 10 count, but I think Will realizes how big this match truly is for both these gentlemen. As much as it pains me to agree with MK, he is right. Sin Bodhi is really, at this point, he is the marker. If you want to get a title shot, you need to go through him. At the same time, if he wins this match, it's going to be a hard, hard, hard dispute to say he does not deserve a shot at Chad Thomas.
No, exactly. And one thing I want to note in terms of just...
Here.
Oh, here we go.
One.
Oh.
It's a one count after the sunset over the top rope there. And a big lariat
and a
by
big
Sin Bodhi.
Line. I mean, see, look at that. That is right there. Sin Bodhi's not a small guy. He knows how to brawl. Let's just cut through the whole, you know, clowny, carny, whatever you want to say, pardon the present company. But he is a fighter.
And it is true. Right now, he's got him in a nasty, nasty leg bar. He has been attacking the arms of Hobo Hank, which is actually quite the smart move, because if you can't lock in that tornado DDT to drive Sin Bodhi's face down to the mat, you've got to come with something else. Now, he's obviously going after the leg. Again, if Hobo Hank cannot get up to that top rope, that tornado DDT is not going to be nearly as effective.
Wholly ineffective. Because that's what Hobo Hank does, and it's very smart. Sin Bodhi, as they say, the KG veteran, going after the leg, grounding him, as they say.
Now, this man here, Sin Bodhi, I mean, he is the Warlord of Weird. He lives that life.
Rope break.
Here we go.
Sorry about that, brother.
That is right. He lives the gimmick, but it is not a gimmick for him. This man is completely and utterly off his rock. We've seen him, you know, doing things in Vegas that no human person should do.
Eating
to his
glass,
body. Hanging,
swallowing swords.
Hanging from hooks. I mean, he is a complete and utter psychopath. But at the end of the day, he is an extremely gifted worker. He is a hell of a brawler. And for Hobo Hank to be in the ring with him, to be hanging with him.
Going
for that DDT. He got out of it.
Once again, look at Hobo limping, favoring his hand, favoring his knee. I mean, I think the tactics of Sin Bodhi may be taking over here.
That is true, and he's going right back to the arm. If you cannot lock into that DDT, you cannot finish with it.
And let me say, all those tactics are 100% legal. He's doing nothing underhandedly.
No, that's exactly right. One thing I want to say really quick here.
Big boot.
Is I want the fans to notice that here at Destiny Wrestling, we're always trying to up the production value. We have a ref cam for the first time ever in Destiny Wrestling. Oh, here we go.
I thought he had it. Not a three. There we go. And right back, tearing at the flesh of Hobo Hank. Now, he has done that more than once. Sin Bodhi knows something about sharp objects. He's
well,
had them
hang,
done
when you
in
hang
their arms.
From hooks.
Exactly.
You know what pain is and how to hurt someone.
And now he's going back. I think he's going to tip back on those arms. I think he's going to try to. Yes, there it is.
Wow.
He yanked those shoulder blades out. I mean, he is going to be utterly, completely inefficient at driving that DDT. Now, MK, here's one thing about that. I will say, he is not just attacking one arm. He is attacking both.
The whole and the chest area, too, when you take that wingspan.
Oh, there
back.
We go. Oh, roll back. Two. Crucifix.
Oh,
no, two count.
Oh, that should have been three. That should have been three. I think, Carney Rob, don't you think that was three? You counted.
Well, you know, and I would hate to say that I'm a better ref than anybody out there, but I do have a good track record of
if it were up to me, Carney Rob would ref every match that I managed.
And hence why you are no longer the director of competition. Nice octopus stretch on the ground there by Sin Bodhi, pulling again at the shoulders. He is working both arms. If you take out one arm, you can lock in that DDT with the other one. If you take out both and they are going dead, I mean literally limp at your body, what are you going to do? You can't punch. You can't protect yourself.
You sure as hell
cannot lock in that tornado DDT.
In boxing, you take away the body, the head will follow. In wrestling, you take away the legs and the arms, your shoulders go onto the mat. Simple as that.
There is a bit of truth from MK, a nugget, if you will. Oh, jawbreaker, which is quite shocking.
Desperation.
In all honesty, coming from our former director of competition. Looks like Sin Bodhi is hung up in the ring. Oh, big gut shot. Oh, there is a shot. Oh, and another one. Oh, and a third.
See, now if Carney Rob was out there, he'd be counting.
Oh! Nasty, nasty
wow.
Lariat. That might do it
That's
for Hobo
gotta
Hank.
Be it. Here it is. It's over.
Ring positioning. Carney, you and I have discussed this. Oh, back to the arm on numerous occasions.
Notice there's no wasted moves from Sin Bodhi.
That is true. The one thing that bit him in the ass right there was the ring positioning. That saved him. Oh, but now he uses the ropes to his advantage. It was a disadvantage right back into advantage for Sin
Bodhi.
And
don't you think it's a psychological message to Hobo Hank? Like, you're going to use the ropes to your advantage. I'm going to show you how the ropes can be used to my advantage.
And the
here
fans,
comes the choke slam.
Here we go. The fans are calling, yes, no, maybe so, sir. Going, talking to his hand. This is an odd thing. I don't know why he does this.
Uh-oh. Here it comes.
Oh! The big choke slam. That is something you are not going to see from anybody else except Sin Bodhi. That is original offense, and it is dominating offense because he is throwing his whole body on the chest of Hobo Hank.
And that's he's what, 235, 240, 6'2"?
Coming down all over him.
Oh, here it goes. Oh. Here it goes.
Double underhook. Oh. Reverse. Here it comes. Is he going to hit the DDT? Oh, no. Neckbreaker.
Big neckbreaker.
I can't believe he pulled it out.
How close were each of those to the DDT?
I mean, both of those right there could have been the finish. Obviously, we know Sin Bodhi has learned the DDT from Jake the Snake's Roberts. That was a double underhook. That was going to
and
be.
And as such, he knows how to counter it.
Exactly. Obviously, we're going in. Big chop there from Hobo Hank. He did deliver that neckbreaker. I mean, he's digging down deep. Those arms have got to be spaghetti, and somehow he is firing them in. Big feet out. Big lariat.
Oh, wow. Turner back. Fair play. Big lariat given by Hobo Hank.
And another one right there. And he is leading him up into the corner here.
Are we going to see that? No.
He's got to soften him up first. You can't just... See, Hobo Hank knows you can't go to it. You've got to soften this guy up.
And, I mean, the fortitude in Hobo Hank is just unmatched. He has been getting his arms laid out.
Here he goes. Can he get it?
Oh, no.
Oh,
shoulder block.
Uh-oh.
And right back. Here we go. Is Sin Bodhi... now he's going for the double underhook. Oh, leg pick by Hobo Hank.
Wrestling by Hobo Hank, countering that.
That is a two count, ladies and gentlemen.
That's something you normally don't see from Hobo Hank.
Oh, no.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
DWOWrestling.com presents Fight or Flight, live September 9th from the Westside Community Center. With titles on the line and Day of Destiny 10 on the horizon, Fight or Flight is promised to be a night of hard-hitting action. This show will be filmed for TV episodes on the ProView Network every Monday at 5:30 p.m. on the Comcast Channel 26. Check us out on Facebook.com/DWOWrestling and at DWOWrestling.com.
Welcome back, wrestling fans. He is obviously, Sin Bodhi is fighting out of that tornado DDT. I'm wondering
hey,
about
look,
this.
Dude, I'm just going to tell you right now.
I am wondering.
If Hobo Hank hooks that in, this might be over. Oh, there we go.
Oh, that was insane right there. I kind of wondered.
I thought Sabu was coming out.
It was weird because I had not heard or seen from Carney Robb there for a moment. It did appear that he might have had something shady to do with that. Something shady. And now my other color, if you will, is getting up. I am left all here alone. Was there some shady tactics there? Those lights might have cued something. Those lights might have cued something from Carney Robb. Where were you, Carney Robb? Those lights went out and you were gone. Where did you go?
You don't worry about where I've been.
Oh, big, nasty, nasty Anaconda DDT by Sin Bodhi. I think this is it. And now, what was this? Was the lights a cue? Because now we've got MK up there. We've got you. You're gone. Now you're back. What is he doing? He's calling for the pin. He's saying, you and I, pin him. That's what he said. What was that plan? The lights go out.
Hey.
Now MK's in the ring. This is shenanigans. You guys are out of control.
You realize you can't just do whatever you want, Carney Rob. You realize MK can't do whatever he wants, Carney Rob.
Why are you putting this blame on me? What happened is we had some technical difficulties. Light went out. I went to go find and turn back on the lights.
Oh, yeah, because the lights went out way after. And that's a nice punch by Sin Bodhi right to your boss. And that's a nice punch for Hobo Hank right to your boss. I think that's fantastic.
And wrong.
Sin Bodhi on top of Hobo Hank. They both want a fair fight. They both want to win this. And is he going to hit it again? The Anaconda DDT. No. Hobo Hank pulls him in. He's setting up for the tornado. He's coming up. Up. Big tornado DDT. Oh, my God. He planted it on Sin Bodhi. He planted it. 2, 3. Oh, he took it. Sin Bodhi took the tornado DDT. He has never been beaten with the DDT, and he got laid out. He got laid out by Hobo Hank, our winner. Right there, ladies and gentlemen. That is a number one contender. That is a man that deserves another shot at the title. And you know what? I am so happy, so happy to see that your boss got punched square in the face.
That was...
In worn out shoes.
What is he doing right now? Again with your theatrics there. He was looking to Hobo Hank. He was saying, good for you. What is that, Carney Rob? Fill me in. Why is your boss now is some sort of cahoots with Hobo Hank? I know that's a lot.
Maybe things just aren't what you believe.
Lights out. Carney Rob gone when the lights are out. Lights come back on. MK in the ring with Hobo, with Sin. And all of a sudden now, Hobo Hank pins the Warlord of Weird, Sin Bodhi. But he is pointing at Hobo, telling him, that's exactly what I wanted.
Colin Mayhem here at DWO True Grit, and I am here with Sin Bodhi. Sin, you said you'd never take a DDT. You know, Jake's your hero, but Hobo Hank got the DDT in on you.
Let me get something straight, man. I DDT'd Hobo Hank first. Put that double butterfly, Tallulah Bell, all over the homeless one. Tallulah Bell is named for my dead sister. Because when she happens, nobody gets up. Neither does she. Bad luck was on my side. You see, Matthew Robles stuck his nose into my business. Now, even though the ref was down and I had the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, cucumber, dump truck, 6, 7, 8 on you, Hobo Hank. Bad luck is luck nonetheless. And your Warlord of Weird fell prey to it. Hobo Hank, I can't be too mad at you for seizing the opportunity. You won that. You did DDT me for the first time in my life. But I'm standing. Still standing. And I will see you again, my friend. Do I look like I'm clowning around?
And we're back here at DWO True Grit. I'm here with Hobo Hank. Hobo, you just took care of Sin Bodhi. Of course, Matthew Robles in the middle of it.
Yeah, it never fails, you know. Matthew Robles, for years, always 2 steps right behind Hobo Hank. I thought maybe I could just go out there and get a victory, not have to worry about him tonight. I know Chad wasn't here tonight, but lo and behold, there he was, like he always is. Regardless, tonight a big, big win against Sin Bodhi. You know, the guy, again, like I said, he's been around the world. He's done it all. So a victory over him was a big, big deal. He was a great competitor. He really brought it out there, and I'm glad that we were able to end it with a handshake. I'm just happy to be closer to DWO Gold.
But more importantly, you ended it with a DDT.
I did. You know, the man said it couldn't be done. Jake, Sin, sorry, you just suffered your first DDT at the hands of Hobo Hank.
That's it for this week, ABQ, but trust me when I say, next Monday, right back here at 5:30 p.m. on ProView TV, you're going to want to come on back because we will finally be showing the main event from DWO True Grit. Witness the controversy for yourself in the tag team title match. It's a lumberyard match. Brute 66 defends against the Colt awaits you.
Thanks for tuning in, fans. Please check us out at DWOWrestling.com, and we'll see you next week.